Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Additionally, if you know of other dog lovers that are not subscribed to Dogumentary TV, please share this video or share your favorite Dogumentary TV video with them. This channel has over 150 million or nearly 150 million views, and we're around 500,000 subscribers. I would love to get this channel up to 1 million subscribers. It would give me so much more leverage when trying to book guests or book interviews for this community. Alright guys, in this video I'm going to do a brief review of the Cane Corso. This information I will be sharing with you in this video will basically be based on my experience as a documentarian, someone who has worked with many breed aficionados, breed professionals, and dog trainers. I myself am a big fan of the Cane Corso. I pretty much have had my eye on this breed for about 12-13 years. For a lot of reasons, I wasn't able to buy a dog, especially a dog of this size, because I lived in apartments. But recently, I just bought a Rottweiler, and it was nip and tuck between the Cane Corso, the Rottweiler, and the Borbal. But this video is about the Cane Corso, so let's jump into the history of this breed. The Cane Corso is an Italian breed. It's the Italian Mastiff. Like many other European breeds, has kind of two histories. The ancient history of the Cane Corso is these dogs are the descendants of Roman war dogs. Dogs that traveled with the Roman soldiers as they conquered Europe. The Cane Corso are the dogs that were left primarily in Italy and southern Italy. As the breed developed in Italy, it was used primarily as a farm and hunting dog. In the 20th century, there were several events that threatened the breed's population in Italy. The World War I, World War II, and the restructuring of the economy, specifically in southern Italy. The livestock that the Cane Corso was entrusted to control was shrinking, and the game the breed hunted was slowly disappearing. By the 1970s, the breed was nearly extinct. In the mid-70s and early 80s, a group of breed enthusiasts got together with the sole purpose of re-establishing the Cane Corso. In 1983, this group established a breed club for the Cane Corso. It was called the Society Amatore Cane Corso. In 1994, the group's work has led to the breed being recognized by the Italian Kennel Club, and in 1996 by FCI. Fast forward to today, the Cane Corso was recognized worldwide as one of the more popular working dog breeds. Today, the Cane Corso is at the height of its popularity. The breed is recognized worldwide for being a strong-willed, loving, powerful, even-tempered working dog. The breed does suffer from some health conditions. They include hip dysplasia, elbow dysplasia, eye problems like entropion and ectropion. As with many dogs, bloat also can be an issue. Additionally, the Cane Corso is one of the breeds more commonly affected by idiopathic epilepsy. In order to ensure the best health outcome for your Cane Corso, you want to be sure that the breeder has performed the appropriate test on your puppy's parents. As the owner of a Cane Corso, you're going to want to be sure to provide your dog with great food, fresh water, great living condition, regular vet visits, and the appropriate amount of exercise. The Cane Corso is a very versatile dog breed and will excel at a lot of different activities. In fact, it is one of the very few master breeds that I would recommend to runners. Now, they're not going to be long distance speed runners, but if you are a jogger, especially a jogger that likes to run trails, hills, outdoors, the Cane Corso is a great breed to take along with you. They will provide you with a certain level of companionship and added security. Today, I see a lot of people using the Cane Corso in protection work, IPO specifically. The thing about this breed is that they very much love their people and they really are people pleasers. So whatever activity it is that you choose to do with your Connie Corso, the likelihood is that your dog will give its best to make you happy and to complete the task that you're asking it to do. All right, guys, listen, if you're looking to get a Connie Corso, I highly recommend this breed. They're great home protectors. They're great companions. These dogs are loving, very easy to live with. If you're looking for a dog, please do your research and make sure that you find an appropriate breeder, someone that's definitely health testing. Large dogs come with large problems, large vet bills, if they're not properly bred and cared for. So do your best right out the gate to make sure you identify a responsible breeder. A good place to start researching for your breed is the American Kennel Club or any kennel club. You can also look at the Connie Corso Club of America or the Connie Corso Club of your country. Additionally, look into protection groups, protection training groups. Like I said, this breed is being used a lot in IPO work. You will find a lot of people with experience with the breed and a lot of great dogs there. All right, guys, good luck on your search. Talk to you on the next one. Peace.